Each year, the Scottish whisky industry spends almost $400,000 to dispose of 827,000 tons of grainy barley kernels, called draff, and about 2 billion liters of a gooey liquid called pot ale. Edinburgh-based Celtic Renewables decided to use an old fermentation process to turn it into fuel. At a recent demonstration, a clear liquid called biobutanol was added to the tank of an ordinary Ford car.
It's quite fitting to use a Ford for this historic drive, as the original Model T Ford ran on biofuel, and the fermentation that we've developed to put the fuel in this car is 100 years old, proven at large scale.
Biobutanol can comprise up to 15% of the gasoline mixture without any modifications to the car's fuel system. It is also less corrosive than ethanol and blends with diesel as well as gasoline.
The opportunities for us in making fuel from the residues of the whisky industry are absolutely enormous, and this could be a giant industry that provides economic and environmental sustainability to one of the biggest industries in the country.
With financial support from the Scottish Government, Celtic Renewables plans to open a factory next year with an annual capacity of 500,000 litres of biobutanol. But the potential is much greater, as the Scottish whisky industry creates enough of the raw materials to scale up that production 100 times. George Putic, VOA News, Washington.